Hi, I'm Belinda Carli, the Director of the Institute of Personal Care Science, and today I want to talk to you about preservatives in personal care. First of all, I'd like to go through some of the reasons why we need good preservatives in most of our personal care products. The first reason is that most personal care is adjusted to be pH compatible with the skin, which is around 5.5. A pH of 5.5 is a compatible pH environment for many fungus and bacteria out there, which means microorganisms will normally grow readily in those pH conditions. A lot of personal care products are also a majority of water. Microorganisms need water to grow and survive, and your personal care products, most of them, are a ready source of water. A lot of your personal care products are also enriched with extracts, plant oils, vitamins and minerals. Again, great food sources for microorganisms. A lot of your personal care products are kept in room temperature conditions or nice, warm, humid bathroom conditions. Again, ideal growth conditions for a majority of your microorganisms. And finally, a lot of personal care products come in open tubs or jars, which means consumers tend to re-dip into them, introducing potential microorganisms throughout their shelf life. So basically, we have product that is water-rich with lots of nutrients in a pH-compatible environment in very nice temperature climate conditions that are potentially being recontaminated on multiple occasions throughout their shelf life. In other words, we have a fantastic source of microorganism growth. So we need to preserve most of our personal care products very carefully to ensure they can maintain a 2 to 3 year shelf life without contaminating us as consumers. Now, there's a lot of misinformation about preservatives out there, so I want to run through a few myths that you might have seen and set the record straight, especially if you're not a chemist, so that you know what is or is not correct information. And I'll also provide you with extra sources you can go to check anything I'm saying for yourself. One of the first myths we see is that essential oils or extracts can help preserve a product. I want to explain that there are thousands of microorganisms, and certain essential oils or extracts may be effective against a very narrow band or a very few of these microorganisms. That's not sufficient coverage to ensure safe use of a personal care product over a 2 or 3 year shelf life for a consumer. So we need to still use broad spectrum preservation to ensure safe use by the consumer, because essential oils or certain extracts will only protect against a very few of the microorganisms that may be introduced to that product throughout its shelf life or may be present already. The next thing I want to explain is that when you have an antibacterial product, it may contain a drug or therapeutic agent that's effective against a certain type of bacteria, but again, the band of protection is too small for the personal care product. So broad spectrum preservation from effective preservatives is also necessary in those product types. Now, I mentioned pH before. Even if you're not a chemist, this has to do with acidity or alkalinity. And some people think, well, if the pH of the product is around 4, as it is for hair conditioners, that will limit growth. It will limit growth of some organisms. And you have to remember, these are very opportunistic organisms. They'll grow whenever it's possible for them to do so. So unless the product has a pH less than 3, which is quite acidic, or a pH greater than 10, which is very alkaline, you can get growth from microorganisms that are readily in the air or in our environments on a daily basis. So again, broad spectrum preservation is required unless a product is below a pH of 3 or above a pH of 10. In all other circumstances where there is a water-rich environment, you need broad spectrum preservation. Also on pH, Sometimes people think, well, if it's a very acid environment, again, we'll use hair conditioners as an example, they think they only need to protect against fungus. That's also not correct. There are plenty of bacteria that are in our environment every day that can grow effectively at a pH of 4. So again, broad spectrum preservation, protection against fungus and bacteria is required anytime a product contains water between pH of 3 and a pH of 10. Some consumers get confused about antioxidants and preservatives. Antioxidants such as vitamin E or rosemary extract will help protect against oxidation. Now, oxidation has a lot to do with rancidity, and it occurs with a lot of our vegetable oils. So when a vegetable oil is used in a formulation, we need to use an antioxidant to help protect against that oil going rancid. But antioxidants do not provide any protection against microorganisms. In fact, your antioxidants, such as vitamin E or rosemary extract, usually act as a food source. They can actually help microorganisms grow. So if there is water present and an antioxidant is used, you're still going to need a preservative. Preservatives protect against microorganisms. Antioxidants protect against oxidation. They're two very different aspects of a formulation. And if vegetable oils are present and water is present, you're going to need both. Another one you may hear out there is if the product contains quaternary agents, it will be self-preserving. This is another myth that doesn't apply to personal care. Where this one has come from is the household industry. So when we make household cleaners, we can use quaternary agents in, say, a floor cleaner, and the pH of that product can be alkaline. Now, we're not applying that product to our skin, so we don't have to worry about pH compatibility. And in alkaline environments, quaternary agents can help preserve a product, but we don't use them in that way in personal care. So in a personal care product, generally when we're using a quaternary agent, we have a pH of around 4 to up to about 5.5, which means it provides no preservation whatsoever. It's only providing its conditioning function. A lot of consumers think that natural preservatives are safer than synthetic preservatives, and that is not true either. There are some natural preservatives, and again, a lot of consumers can be misled to think that some more preservatives are natural when they're not. Some classic examples you may think are natural are things like sorbic acid, potassium sorbate, sodium benzoate. Now, these particular preservatives in personal care are synthetically produced. They are identical to the preservatives that occur in nature, but they are not natural. In personal care products, these particular preservatives, as an example, are produced in large quantities synthetically because it would not be economically viable to produce them from their natural sources. Now again, they do occur in nature, but they do not occur from natural sources in personal care products. Those preservatives are synthetic. There are some other natural preservatives used in personal care products. They are quite expensive, so their use is often limited, and a lot of the natural preservatives also don't work much above a pH of 5 or 5.5. So there's only certain types of personal care products that a lot of the natural preservatives actually suit. One of the great things about our industry and the continued interest in natural ingredients is we are seeing more natural preservatives become available that do support a broader pH compatibility. But that's a discussion for a chemist. For a consumer, what you need to know is that what you may have been told is natural may not actually be natural, and that there is no scientific evidence to support the statement that natural is safer than synthetic. In fact, a lot of synthetic preservatives are rigorously tested to ensure safety, even in baby personal care products and products for use on the mucous membranes, for instance, dental hygiene products. So natural does not mean safer. In fact, there's plenty of very mild and safe synthetic preservatives used in personal care today. Finally, let's tackle the big one. A lot of misinformation on the internet would lead you to believe that some preservatives used in personal care products pose a risk to your health. It is simply not true or not justified for this information to be saying so. Now, there are some great regulatory links. You can contact us for a written copy of this report, and I'll provide those links to you so you can go and do the research for yourself. The two key ones I want to talk to you about is parabens, and the second one is formaldehyde releases. The first one, let's talk about parabens. Now, there have been rigorous studies done by multiple regulatory agencies around the world that have conclusively proven that when parabens are used within regulatory limits, their use is safe, even from cumulative exposures on a daily basis from multiple personal care products. They've taken that into consideration. The other thing I'd like to point out is there are strict regulations about preservative use in pretty much every country around the world. It's one of the things as formulators we need to learn specifically to make sure we use preservatives within regulatory limits. And those regulatory limits are set to ensure safe use by our consumers. Now let's talk about formaldehyde releases. There are some preservatives used in personal care that are recognized as releasing formaldehyde in a personal care product. It has been conclusively proven that the amount that are limited in personal care products when used within those limits, and again, it's a regulatory consideration, they must be used within those limits, they are then considered safe when used within those limits. So yes, there are some preservatives that will release formaldehyde in a formulation, but there have been a lot of studies done about the potential absorption of these materials through dermal application, through cumulative exposures in a single day to ensure safety by the consumer. Again, if you'd like a copy of this information and links that go to the websites that show you the full data that backs up everything I say, please contact us and we'll happily give them to you. Well, I hope you found this video informative. Even if you're not a formulator, hopefully I've explained some of the key reasons we need preservatives in personal care, some of the key myths that are out there about preservatives, and I've hopefully also made you feel better about the use of certain preservatives in your personal care. Happy formulating!